All right, let me finish now.
Mon heta.
Alleluia.
Amen.
When you are praying,
loko miri ku khongeleni,
you must always remember the key of the door of your answers.
Mi fanekele mi kari hinkwayo mi tsunduka xikhiya xa xa rivanti xa tinhlamulo ta n'wina. Amen.
Always remember the key of the door of your answers.
Tsundukani xikhiya xa rivanti xa tinhlamulo ta n'wina mi kari hinkwayo.
Let us read from the book of Matthew chapter 16 verse 19.
Ai hlayeni ka buku ya Matthew chapter 16 verse 19.
Jesus says,
yes,
and I will give you the keys of the kingdom of heaven. Whatever you forbid on earth will be forbidden in heaven. And whatever you permit on earth shall be permitted in heaven. We continue. John 16 verse 23. And at that time, you will not ask me for anything. I tell you the truth. You will ask the Father directly. He will give you your request because you use my name. You have not used my name before. Ask now. Using my name, you will receive and you will have abundant joy. The name of Jesus is your key. When you pray, you must say in the name of Jesus. When you say something, you must mention the name of Jesus. The name of Jesus, it's a key. Whatever you are asking, the name of Jesus shall unlock it, shall open it, because it is the key. The name of Jesus, it's a key. He says, whatever you forbid here on earth, it shall be forbidden in heaven. The name of Jesus will allow you to forbid what you don't need and to accept what you need in the name of Jesus. Whatever is not wanted in your family, in your life, in your children, in your grandchildren, I forbid it in the name of Jesus. I forbid it in the name of Jesus. I forbid it in the name of Jesus. I forbid it. The name of Jesus is the key. I am using it. I forbid poverty in your family. I forbid sicknesses in your family. I forbid downfall in your position. I forbid in the name of Jesus. Whatever you permit in your family, in the name of Jesus, I am permitting joy. I am permitting peace. I am permitting victory. I am permitting salvation. I am permitting breakthrough. 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 I am permitting houses. I am permitting to come to your family. I am permitting education to come to your children. Mathematics and sciences. I permit. Alleluia.
Amen.
Now look.
Sevonani.
Look.
Vonani.
When children are crying without stopping, maybe it's a little child, you must wake up and say, hey, No spirit. I forbid you. Leave my grandchild. Leave my child. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Huh?
Amen.
That letter.
Papilarero.
And message.
Nahungu.
Which was coming.
Lera rikuteni.
Saying.
Riku.
Debt.
Shukweleti.
Debt.
Shukweleti.
Now.
Sheshi.
In the name of Jesus.
Evita ra Yesu.
I forbid them.
Nara alela.
I forbid.
Naala.
I forbid.
Naala.
I forbid.
Naala.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Bonan.
Now look.
We Christians.
He never Christian.
Ah.
Amen.
We are having a master key.
He na si key acha kupula inkuako.
Chopulati nyangua inkuato. The name of Jesus.
Vitora Yesu.
Is a master key.
He si key acha kupulati nyangua inkuato.
Whatever you don't want.
Ne si inkuasho munga silaveki.
You forbid.
Masu alena.
And you lock.
Mekela me key.
Whatever you need.
Ne si mishi lava.
You unlock.
Makinu.
And you take it.
Teka.
Lift up your hands. Let me see the key in your hands. With that key, there is no door you cannot open. There is no door you cannot open. I see the doors of your finances are getting open. I see the doors of your businesses are getting open. I see the doors of your healing are getting open. They are getting open.
Amen.
Huh?
Amen.
When you arrive home.
Loko mifika kaya.
This is your homework.
Lei homework ya nwina ntiro kaya wa nwina.
Hold the key.
Khoma ni skia.
As you approach your gate.
Loko mifika gate ya nwina.
You say.
Meku.
Here I open the blessings.
La lupula mikateko.
Let the blessings of salvation come in my family.
Let
the blessings of employment come in my family. Let the business of money come into my family. When I'm gonna blah blah, 1 million, 2 million.
Those of you who spoke about millions, 2 millions. I'm asking to add some more zeros right at the end.
So that it can become trillion.
Let's talk about trillion.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now, who can steal your master key?
Sena imananga iba kusikia shangu na chaku pula timbati hukwa tuke.
No one.
Kuhaba na umwe.
Because your master key.
Hukuba sikia shangu na chaku pula timbati.
Is not in the pocket.
Asile shukwamele.
Is not in the house.
Asile ndenika imwe.
Is inside your heart.
Asile ndenika mbili ya wina.
Hallelujah. Huh? You go to the garage.
Mia garage.
They say.
Baku.
How much do you have?
Sana mina malu munike.
I have all money.
Mekuni na mali kwayo.
In your pocket.
Ashkwa mensha wina.
No money.
Akuna mali.
In your heart.
And then kambili ya wina.
There is all money.
Kuna mali kwayo.
Your key is in your heart.
Sikia shanguna silende ni kambili ya wina.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Your key is in your heart.
Shikia shanguna silendeni kambilu ya wina.
Hallelujah. Huh? Oh. Thank you very much. We may sit down.
Can see the shunene, we got some hands.
When you pray, the motives of your prayers are very important. Write it down. The motives of your prayers. What are the motives of your prayer? Many people can pray, but their motives are different. Some motives are pleasing God. Some motives are pleasing people who are praying. It is very important to have a motive that pleases God in your prayer.
Hallelujah. Amen.
Motive. 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 Write this book. I will not read it now. 1 Kings chapter 18 verse 18. Elijah said,
Eliyahu,
O Lord of Abraham, Isaac and Jacob,
answer
me, prove today that you are the God, I am your servant, prove that I have done this at your command. Answer me so that these people will know that you are the Lord. Now listen. Whether you are asking for a job, a marriage, a house, or money, your motive must be for God to be known. When your people see your house, they must see God. When people see your car, they must see God. When people see your money, they must see God. When God promote you, when people see your position, they must see God. Elijah said, answer my prayer so that these people, they shall know you are the God of Israel. He does not say, answer my prayer so that they will know me. No. Answer my prayer so that these people shall know you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Look.
Vonani.
When God promotes you to the higher position, and you are born again, you go to the church, you pray, you are filled with love. Someone who have nothing, he look at you. If that person who is in a high position is a Christian, who am I that I must not be born again? I must follow that person. In other words, your position is helping others to see God. It's helping others to know God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Huh?
Amen.
If you are having a high position, you don't believe in God, you don't love God, people who don't have positions, they say, maybe God, it's not the real God. Why are these people not going to God? But if you are having a high position, you are submissive to God. poor, people who are in need, who don't have positions, when they look at you, they begin to fear God. They say, if this man who have all things loves God, follow God, who we are, that we must not follow God, then they believe in God. And when you make God be known by your position, He lifts you more higher and higher and higher and higher. Tell your neighbor, say, neighbor. God is promoting you more. You must not be like Nicodemus, who went to see Jesus by night because he was having a position.